really want to do is something that we'll be announcing during the festival, which is to bolster distribution of independent cinema, which we feel is a big gap in our country. You know, we've never had, for instance, our films, for our films to even travel to international festivals, filmmakers themselves have to spend the money both to apply and to travel. And there isn't a well, you know, sort of developed system of distribution and exhibition, exhibition of course, but distribution of Indian independent films, both in India and abroad. So we're hoping we've got something that we've been working on, which we'll announce during the festival. But this is, these are the things that we feel as a an academy we can do. Of course, ideally, we would just like people to be more open to watching the kinds of films that you're talking about. What, you know, the films with the laurel wreaths, which people get worried are boring. We want to change that perception. We want people to say, wow, okay, this film's been at Sundance, it's been at Mami, it must be a good film, let's go see it. So, so yeah, it's a slow process. I mean, I think for the younger generation, folks under 30, under 35, they're anyway consuming a lot of this kind of cinema on digital and other ways.
What it also does, and I'll speak from personal experience, what festivals do to many a times to a film is it gives them visibility that it sometimes very sorely needs. Like for our movies like Haramkor and Peddlers, which never came out here, got visibility because of Mami. Haramkor eventually got released, got picked up by Netflix. You know, a lot of films. Whereas the indie cinema versus the mainstream cinema, the what so-called commercial cinema, that divide is across the world. That divide is across the world. But a lot of indie films come to the festivals. You see a lot of Sundance movie actually go straight to digital. All of them don't get a release. But it draws attention. For example, Fandry was at Mami before it went to Berlin. And it traveled. And a film, when it shows at a home festival, it is eligible for world premiere at all the festivals. Big festivals will still pick them up. So Mami gives that eligibility to Indian films, and also there's a lot of programmers, buyers, agents, salespeople who attend Mami, and they, if you see them, they will actually be going and watching films at India Gold more than international movies, because they're literally coming here to pick the Indian films. It really is a big help, and I've benefited a lot from it. So I can speak from personal experience. It really helps. Whereas, yes, sometimes films struggle for a theatrical release in India because then you're dealing with a different mindset. But if once at Mami, the film gains so much traction that you will get that door leg into the distributors or the any kind of a presenter's office that you would not before Mami. A lot of films have benefited like that.
Hi, this is Harshita here.
Anurag ji, my question to you is, last year there was an experience ki sham ko 6 baje ek film start honi thi aur aapka session tha 6 baje ka. आप कुछ 6:30 बजे आए, इट स्टार्टेड एंड इट लास्टेड वन एंड हाफ आवर, डेढ़ घंटे का चला, तो फिल्म गॉट स्टार्टेड बट 8:30 or 9. ऐसा प्रैक्टिस ना हो उसके लिए आपने क्या सोचा, लोगों का टाइम ना खराब हो, फिल्म आप ही का सेशन था वो?
नहीं, मुझे नहीं मालूम.
पर्सनल अपॉलॉजी सर दैट यू हैड टू वेट
लास्ट ईयर. ये कौन सा सिनेमा था? लास्ट ईयर तो मैं जूरी में था. मैं तो
यू नो अनफॉर्चुनेटली चीजें कभी कभी होती हैं, एज यू नो.
हो सकता है,
बट आई डोंट, आई मीन आई, वी डोंट रिकॉल दिस पर्टिकुलर इंसिडेंट.
आई एम अ वेरी पंक्चुअल पर्सन, सो इट हैज टू बी सम अदर रीजन.
हाय, आई गॉट अ क्वेश्चन. हर्षदा हियर. कुड यू जस्ट टेल अस समथिंग अबाउट द इंटरनेशनल एरिना, लाइक हु ऑल सेलिब्रिटीज आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग और व्हाट ऑल फिल्म्स आर कमिंग इन?
फोक्स, वी फॉरगॉट. We have to introduce the jury, international jury, to you. Without further ado, so John Madden will be the head of jury, and the rest of the jury are the cinematographer Alexis Zabe, the actress Selena Jade, the actress and director Konkana Sen Sharma, and the director Santiago and writer Santiago Mitre. Actor, I should say, but whatever.
What all films been part of this festival, the international film?
Sorry?
The prominent international or the world cinema for this Mami?
So we will have announcements coming at different stages. So please keep your eyes out. Kiran, this is as much as we are announcing today, actually.
Yeah, hi. Hi, Kiran ma'am.
Sorry? Yes, Kiran, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I want to know whether the short movies will also be screened. And other question is, what is the role of the Tata Sky?
Why does it, I mean, okay, I'll take it. Short films, actually, we have a separate vertical, as Anu mentioned, called the Royal Stag Short Film Contest, which happens separately and not during the festival. It's a separate vertical that Mami actually helps to curate the films for, and Royal Stag gives a prize for.
And I also want to ask Kaushik Roy to speak here, because we've launched a mentorship and short filmmaking vertical, a studio.
Yeah, since the question is about short films, I'm happy to mention this as a sponsor, which is Jio. We don't really believe in signing a check, so we have been, I think they'll agree that we've actually gone ahead and done a lot of things. For instance, there was no Jio when we started this sponsorship. It was very crazy that there were people asked us, what is Jio? So it's only 1 year that we have been in business as Jio, but we've been sponsors for 2 years. This is the third year, and we're happy to continue. So in this, one of the commitments that we'd made was we would look at short films and the in digital kind of format. We have achieved something which I can quickly share, which is pretty unique in the sense that we had a contest in which we got 900 entries by way of synopsis and a kind of treatment note, from which we narrowed it down to 25 top who we invited to Mumbai for a residential masterclass. We also had an online masterclass which was open to every entrant. The good thing is that we've managed to get people who have barely made any kind of films, and we've got 10 films, and these are 10 short films. Yes, it is a separate vertical, but we are proud to say that it's going to be part of the festival. It will be a jury which is going to be appointed by Mami, who will see this. And we will have the screening for these 10 films, under 10-minute short films, which are going to be, in a way, an experiment where we've gone about picking a kind of entry, which is just a synopsis, to mentoring them and financing them to have these 10 films.
I'll just quickly answer your Tata Sky question. So Tata Sky came forward themselves and said that they wanted to showcase films that Mami had curated for the festival. And we were delighted because, as you know, there's no better audience than the big television audience. There's no better way to reach the audience than television. So they did this last year, and this year again they are partnering with us to have what is called the Mami Specials. And I think there's around 15 to 20, or there's 30 films this time that will be showcased, and we'll be announcing that as well shortly. I just also would like for Sid, Kostub, and Rohan to just share with us their, you know, feelings about this year, anything that they wanted to talk about now that we are launching our third, we're in our third year, and all of them have been partners with us now for 3 years.
Thanks, Kiran. No, it's just wonderful to see it keep growing. I was telling Kiran, I was here when my father was part of the board for the first one, where Amir was preparing the speech to give Dev Saab at YB Chauhan Center when we started off. So it's wonderful to see that it's still moving and growing all the time. Particularly lovely, these initiatives of, as a filmmaker, to see word-to-screen market, things like that take off, because to answer the question about for Bollywood or other filmmakers, that becomes a very useful place. You meet 30 publishers, maybe there are 100, 200 books written by Indian authors that you can look at. So I think all these things, as they keep growing, it becomes a bigger and broader festival. And yeah, just happy to be part of this, and yeah, privileged to be part of this team, and looking forward to what comes next this year and beyond.
Government of Maharashtra has been associated with the Mami Festival. This is the third year now. I remember very vividly when Kiran and Anupama had come down to Mantralaya and given a very detailed presentation and had asked for government support. And we are extremely excited that the way this entire festival has grown the opportunity that it provides not only the people of Mumbai, but in terms of filmmakers and the various initiatives they take throughout the year. I think government's jobs is cut out. We just need to make sure that we enable such festivals. This is one of the most vibrant cities in the country. And it's a place where movies are made. I mean, the most creative and talented people in the industry stay in Mumbai, and Mumbai loves the movies, and we fully support this initiative. This year, in fact, is the Maharashtra tourism year. So we anticipate that a lot of activities associated with the government will be part of the Mami Film Festival. And on behalf of the government, we are there with the festival to make sure that it's a grand success. We need to make this the finest and the best festival in the world, and that's the vision.
You know, for years, we'd all been bemoaning the fact that a city like Mumbai didn't have a film festival that it really did deserve. I mean, the fact that this is the birthplace of Indian cinema and we didn't have a world-class film festival was obviously a matter of grave concern to many of us, but none of us really did anything about it. So I just want to say that in 2014, when really Kiran and Anu got involved with the festival and virtually resurrected it from the state that it was in, the sort of strides that it's made in the last 3 years are, it's really quite incredible. There's been just a 180 degree shift from where we were to where we are today. And of course, there's lots more to do, but since I am the last speaker, I just wanted to take this opportunity, since all of us have been thanked, but really to thank Kiran and Anu for the incredible work that they've done in being able to make this festival what it is. Smriti, absolutely. I'm just saying because you thanked her already, so. Yeah, thank you.
So just one last word from the woman of the moment who's running the show, who's going to tell you how she feels before the curtains go up.
Guys, register for the festival. Don't ask for free passes. Please invest. We have no money. Just come for the festival. We've got a really nice movie feast for you. And thank you so much for supporting us. It means a hell of a lot. We have no money to buy media. So we are really, really asking you to go out there, write about us, spread the word, be the warriors of movies with us and do this. Thank you.